Good afternoon, everyone. I'm going to talk about today about document visual similarity measures for document search. So as for problem statement, we can say that we want to have means to compare documents with respect to their visual similarity. We do not consider the content of the document, what the document talks about. We would rather like to compare layouts and images in the document, such that similar documents would be and have some means, have some algorithm that would be enable us to find similar documents in a very large document data set. So, as a possible application would be something like an entrepreneur would like to advertise his business, and he would like to come up with a brochure, and he would have an idea about what he would like to have in his brochure, and he would be provided a large data set of brochures that are designed, that are prepared by the professional designers, and he would have means to visually find documents, brochures that are similar to what he has in his mind, but created by a professional designer. So this is a screenshot of Snapfish web page where the service is greeting cards. So as an additional application would be organizing documents or greeting cards with respect to their visual similarity, such that users might find greeting cards of their specific interest rather by searching by their visual similarity rather than by the keyword. Or newspaper catalog search is another application. So our approach to this problem is basically comparing documents with respect to three different components. There's component for background, text, and saliency. Background component is basically the component where we have the background without text. We erase all the text from the background, and then we use the document, we extract feature vectors from every pixel of the document. So it's five-dimensional. First of all, it's x, y, which is the position of a pixel, and LAB color values. So from every pixel of the background component, we extract one feature vector. And then we run EM algorithm to find out, to learn a Gaussian mixture model. And then we compare, and then we, the number of mixture models is basically calculated by the MDL, minimum description length cost function. So we learn a Gaussian mixture model that basically represents position of a pixel given the color of this pixel at the background. Here, what we can mention here as the visualization of the Gaussians can be as follows. So since the Gaussians, since the feature vectors are five-dimensional, they're impossible to show on a plane. So the best thing we can do is actually we can show each Gaussian as an ellipsoid and give its mean color. Since the feature vectors each have a color, then the mean color would be actually can be given to the whole Gaussian. And here you can see a document next to its background component and next to the ellipsoids that represents the whole Gaussian mixture model for the background component. Another visualization of this approach would be as follows. So by the maximum likelihood function, we can assign every pixel its color of its closest Gaussian. So if we have five Gaussians, for example, here, then the corresponding segmentation, where we'll have five colors to assign to each pixel, would be as follows, and we can run this experiment for as many Gaussians that we can have, and you can see that there is a big difference in the number of Gaussians between 13 and 28 Gaussians, but in terms of segmentation, there is not a lot difference. So we actually end up with number of Gaussians in between 10 and 15, so we don't have more than 15 Gaussians in our mixture model for this application. For text component, we do similar algorithm. We extract Gaussian mixture model, but then in this case we only consider pixels of text boxes. So basically we take pixels x, y, only the coordinates of pixel at every text box, and we disregard everything else. So we learn Gaussians, and these are the actual Gaussians. Since they're two-dimensional, we can show them on the screen. This is the representation of the Gaussian mixture model. And then for the saliency component, we the saliency is basically given as the Euclidian distance between LAB color values of every pixel and the average LAB color of the whole document. So it is basically given by this formula. So it is the feature vectors now are three dimensionals that are given by the position of a pixel, x, y values, the coordinates, and the third coordinate would be the saliency value. So saliency, why do we pay attention to the saliency? Saliency is basically represent the areas or the regions in the document that are significantly more visual in a way. Actually, they would stand out with respect to its neighborhood. So for example, this one comparing documents, we would like to find a document that would be similar to this one where the instead of the dancing persons here, it would have some other salient portion, maybe some inscription or some text that would have also these salient properties at the same place. And so once we have learned the Gaussian mixture models for every component, we now would like to have some means to compare Gaussians. So we compare Gaussians by the Hellinger distance, which is basically the distance that we can calculate, that we can find comparing two different probability distributions. So for probability distributions F and G, the Hellinger distance would be the scaled square root of the 1/2 norm between these two distributions, the square roots of these two distributions, which can be simplified into this single form, where it is basically the square root of 1 minus the Batachere coefficient in between two different distributions, F and G. And if we expand the Batachere coefficient, we basically see that this is nothing else but the expectation of the square root of the ratio between the two distributions under one of them. And it is also symmetric, so we can actually play around with exchanging distribution P by Q, and we can have another form of expressing Batachere coefficient, but in terms of expectation of another distribution. The Batachere coefficient, in order to compare the distribution, we approximate Batachere coefficient by the Unscented Transform. Unscented Transform is used to approximate expectation of a nonlinear function h of x under probability distribution, well, in this case, f of x. So this is basically done in the following way. We specifically choose points at certain locations for the distribution f, and we evaluate evaluate the function h at these specific points, and then we take the scaled sum of the obtained values, and this would be the approximation of the expectation. Now, in terms of Gaussian, it would be best actually if we just take these points that are certain that would capture the true mean and variance of the distribution. So, for example, if we want to find expectation under some specific function h of x, where the probability distribution is given by this ellipsoid, then the points that we choose actually would be on the two sides of the mean, and that would be the square root of column of a covariance matrix away from the mean. And so by taking the mean of these points, we would have an approximation of the expectation of this of the nonlinear function h. And so once this is the ways to calculate distances between Gaussian mixtures, and since I've mentioned before we have three components, now that we know how to compare these three components, the question is how do we come up with an ultimate measure in between the documents. So to do that, we basically come up, we search for weights, WB standing for the weight for background component, WT, which is the weight for the text component, and the weight for the saliency component. And then we weight the distances, and we search for the weighted sum of these distances to come up with the ultimate measure between document similarities. And to do that, we define a probability function, which is expressed in this way. And this is the probability function that document J is the neighbor of document I. And then if we have classes of similar documents in our data set, then we can set probability PI, which would be a probability that document I is correctly classified, that all of its neighbors that are in class CI are close to it. And then we can sum them, this PI with respect to all of the classes that we have in our data set, and we can come up with the cost function that would basically be the probability that all of the documents are correctly classified. And the good thing about this function is that it is differentiable, and we can run gradient ascent algorithm, all sorts of optimization algorithms on this function to find the optimal weights for our application. And so for our testing components, testing and training, we use the 410 documents from five different classes. You can see example samples from our data set. And we ran a threefold cross-validation technique. And here are the results of our three runs for our cross-validation. So the cross-validation basically works in the way that we divide every class into three parts. We train on two parts and test on another, and then we switch them, and then we do that three times, and these are the results. And as for small demo, I would like to show you the following. So here for the demo, we have a data set of approximately 2,020 documents here. They're very different in their stylistic features. And what we can do is, the simplest demo would be basically to find a document here, an index of a document, and run and find four of the most similar ones. For example, then the query document would be on the right, on the left, and the four that are most similar documents to this one with respect to visual similarity would be shown next to it. And the same way, we can run this experiment a few times. For, let me just choose a very different example, something of this sort, and the algorithm basically gives me this. So all these documents are considered to be similar with respect to our similarity measure in their stylistic features. This is it. Thank you very much.
Hey, do we have any questions for Ildus about his work?
Yeah.
Andrew.
I'm just curious, and if I had the answer to this question, I would ask it more specifically. At CHI this year, Scott Klemmer's group presented a style matching based on a sort of a visual feature model that kind of reminded me a little bit of the last paper, but not exactly at all, but sort of in the same vein. And I just wondered if you... So you're familiar with that?
Are you referring to bricolage paper?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I guess they have a WIST paper in a few weeks. Too.
Yeah.
So I was just wondering if you could compare and contrast the two approaches.
Yeah, that's right. Well, that's a very good question, actually. We had I've been invited to a few seminars to their group, actually, and what they do is they compare layouts of web pages, and whereas we basically concentrate on the actual PDF documents. So, but apart from that, our approaches are similar, yes. But the thing is, they're using tree-based algorithms, so they compare trees, which is a different problem. Well, but the thing is, the comparing tree algorithms might be NP-complete, so they might run into some difficulties, whereas this is not very robust, but, well, more robust, but a little bit more simple approach to this problem.
So what do you think the implications of that are for how useful the two approaches are and on what kinds of problems?
Well, applications will be totally different, actually. The first, their approach would be just to come up with a website that has the layout of certain layout that is similar to the websites that the user has chosen. Whereas in our case, we have actual brochures, and we would be basically comparing the documents, single-page documents in here. We do not consider web pages because they can be very different, actually. But here we have certain margins and certain limitations to the PDF documents that we use. I'm not sure if I asked your question, but we can talk later, I guess, if you want.
I don't really have a question, but I thought that it was nice. I liked the work. It was interesting to see your success. Nice demo.
Thank you.
So, okay, let's thank our speaker. Thank you.